Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel, it's Cynic Alex, and today I want to take an in-depth look at Scarlet Witch's new uniform, and I think one of the most highly anticipated uniforms in a long time. And I want to talk about all of the skill changes because there's been a lot of tinkering done at a very, you know, micro level for this uniform. So I want to let you know all of the things that I've observed and I've calculated and seen. Give you some skill rotation examples and some gameplay, and then discuss where I think this uniform is going to land this character kind of in the future of the game. Additionally, I would like to know who you'd like me to focus on next, or what you'd like to see for tomorrow's video. For example, I still have a lot of ideas coming out, but I'd like to maybe focus my efforts a little bit more depending on what you guys want to see most. So I appreciate your input on that. So jumping right in, there's actually a lot more than simply the skill changes as far as the damage or the skill animations go from her base uniform to her new Marvel Infinity War look. So that is going to be the comparison I'm going to be making. Obviously, she does more damage because with a uniform, you get a huge stat bonus. I'm at Legendary. Once you get to Mythic, it's a 25% all attack increase plus all the other stats. That there's no doubt about that. And of course, with her uniform, she has a bonus. She boosts her mind damage by 20%, which is a big deal. She gets an additional effect on her recovery spell, 4-star passive, and she just always has a 15% physical damage reduction. So that's kind of the first thing to point out. And she gets an additional 10% energy damage reduction when she uses her third skill, Hex. So she's got between 10 and 15% all damage reduction, basically at all times. Her heal is the same, it's still 15% for 1 second, and the reflect is the same, but that's a pretty sizable defensive bonus on top of the stats that she's getting from the uniform. But in addition to that, there were quite a few changes made to the character's skills. The biggest change I think that you guys are going to notice, we've talked about this already, is that the second skill has lost its iframe. The good thing about the second skill is that the effect will happen immediately, the damage, and they've gotten rid of those silly kind of orbs that surrounded her. So you can cancel out of the second skill very quickly, and I think you should make a habit, if you're playing her manually, to cast the second skill for the damage, but immediately cancel it into another skill, because it's one of those abilities where once she begins the animation, it will continue regardless of whether she's doing something else. It's a cancelable effect that still does residual damage. So just keep that in mind when you're building her skill rotation or when you're actually in the middle of a fight. You can just do two cancel anything else, and you'll get a bunch of extra damage added. One of the other big changes that I noticed was pretty clever on their part. They actually took the defensive bonuses of the third skill and the fourth skill, which were damage immunity and guard hit, and they just basically swapped them. So with Scarlet Witch's original uniform, she had immunity for 5 seconds on her third skill, Hex Blast, and she had a guard hit on her fourth skill. What that ended up doing was basically, with her original uniform, it was very useless almost to use Chaos Sphere because it was a slow attack. The damage wasn't very good because you had to be really close to the enemy, and it was a guard hit, so it's very easy to punish that. And most characters nowadays can get off 8 hits very quickly, the likes of Jean Grey, Nova, Wolverine, Quicksilver, etc. So it basically offered her very little protection. Meanwhile, Hex just overloaded with stat bonuses, reflect, summons, heal, removal of, you know, enemies' effects, and the immunity. So they basically stacked too many good abilities on one skill, and it made Scarlet Witch's rotation kind of frustrating to use. It was kind of just like 1-2 for the iframe, and then 3, and then sometimes 5, but never 4. So I do really appreciate the fact that they went ahead and noticed that and kind of tried to spread her out a little bit more, because there's nothing really fun about playing a character who only has one or two abilities that you want to use and the other ones you just ignore because they're not as good. It's much better to have a character where you can utilize 4 or 5 skills in tandem, and you really feel like you're doing a whole bunch of different moves in kind of a rhythmic pattern to get your successful outcome, which is winning. So I do really appreciate that. They moved the guard hit over to the third skill. They moved the immunity over to the fourth skill, which makes the fourth skill a lot better to do. And they changed the fourth skill around, so we'll talk about that in a minute. The other big thing with the third skill is that they added some additional effects, but they also reduced some of the effects. So in addition to the iframe loss on the second skill, they reduced the guard hit. It used to be 8 hits for 8 seconds, which is primo, and they made it 5 hits for 5 seconds. So that offers very little protection nowadays with this kind of attack speed and number of hit heavy meta. So her third skill is actually quite a vulnerable skill to use, but it's buffed not only by her increased defenses from her uniform bonuses that we've already mentioned, but they've added additional effects. They added the remove active buff from the target. That was never an effect, and that's a very powerful effect at that. You can remove some pretty, you know, sizable bonuses from a character, from an enemy, if they're they have like their shield up, for example. You can take away their invincibility shield. And they also added the mind resistance and the all defense down. So it's got some additional debuff properties against the enemy, in addition to that, also the 10% energy damage reduction received on her 4-star passive, which is kind of linked to her third skill. So her third skill does even more now. And of course, they took away the summons as well, but that was already kind of to be expected. But the removal effect of HP recovery, that is all still the same. And everything else is the same. The damage is better now on her third skill because it has a channeling effect. So this is the skill Hex Blast that you want to end your rotation on for damage procs. You want to try to land your damage proc on this skill in addition to the fourth skill. So we'll get into that a little bit later. For the fourth skill, they made it much better in terms of the damage. It's a huge burst damage skill. It also adds the all defense. It also adds mind control. So the mind control is a new ability for Scarlet Witch. It's 5 seconds. From what I've heard, it works against world bosses as well. So it's a very good skill to be utilized in basically any game mode. And it also gives the enemy, they will take more damage from all sources. So this has utility as well in 3v3 PvP scenarios like Conquest, like Alliance Tournament. So we'll have to see. 6% is not much, but every little bit counts when you're, you know, going down to the wire. The mind resistance was the same, and then like I said, they took the 5 seconds of immunity from her third skill and moved it over to her fourth skill, so that's the same. But her fourth skill is very much like Nova's fifth skill. It creates just kind of a colored energy source right out of the person's body, in this case out of Scarlet's body, and then it just kind of pulsates in the area, and it has quite a wide AoE despite not seeming to be very big in and of itself. So the animation, it does betray the power and the impact of the skill a little bit, but it's an extremely powerful skill, and you should try to land your proc on this skill in addition to the third skill. Her fifth skill is basically exactly the same as it is with her other uniform. You got a bunch of meteors, or some meteors plus the ground rocking, and then she rides down on a meteor. The frustrating thing about this skill, or the thing that makes this skill a little bit worse, is that the buff, Collapsing Reality, comes at the very end of the skill. So if you cast this and you cancel it, you may get some of the damage, but you will not get the buff. So you have to ride this effect out, literally, until the end to get the buff. So for that reason, you want to do this at the end of your first rotation and have it up for the following rotations, but not to open up your assault, because you'll lose the damage proc on this skill, and it really doesn't do as much as her others. And her first skill, I didn't cover before, but it's exactly the same as her other skill. It's got the little squares, they reduce the character's size, and it has those buffs with the bind as well. So as far as the rotation goes for this character, definitely I would say the most aggressive rotation possible would be to open up with the 2 skill, immediately cancel into 4, immediately cancel into 3. Doing that in quick succession, the 2 skill should proc your obelisk damage proc. The fourth skill and the third skill should in tandem simultaneously benefit from the damage buff, 180%, 160%, 200%, and then you would ride out that third skill, which you'll see it's a channeling skill, for about 3 to 4 seconds. And then when that's finished, or your damage proc is finished, you can do either 1 cancel 5. You can ride out the 1 skill. The 1 and 5 both have iframe, so it's really what you'd rather do. 5 does more damage and has the buff, so you definitely want to do 5. But 1 has the debuff, so you might want to just cancel 1 to get those, you know, minus 20 attack, minus 20 defense on the enemy. 8 seconds is long enough, and then, you know, quickly cancel into 5. You should have enough time, depending on how quick your attack speed is, to get through the full full animation of 5 before going back into 2 cancel, 4 cancel, 3 to continue your assault. If you want a slightly more defensive rotation, you would do 4 cancel, 2 cancel, 3, because 4 will give you the immunity, whereas 2 does nothing for you defensively. There's no guard hit, there's no heal, there's no iframe or anything like that. But that would be the rotation, and those are the full list of skill changes for Scarlet Witch. It's quite substantial and quite extensive in terms of moving things around and adding things, but also taking things away. I want to show you the rotation in action now against a very easy Shadowland stage, just so you can get a grasp on just how it will look. We're going to go against a similar stage so we don't blow through it in 1 second, but her damage output is absolutely ridiculous. And as soon as I can find Scarlet Witch, because she's hiding from me, I have to get used to all these new portraits. I'll be able to, this is like a running theme now where I just can't find her hair. It's just, it's too orange. It's not red, and I'm used to the red helmet, so don't blame me. Blame the person who made the icon. It looks too much like someone else. I don't know. But we're here, we're gonna do 2 cancel, 4 cancel, 3. And here you can see the channeling skill. And then we can do 1 cancel, 5. We can rock them out. And then again, 4 cancel, 2 cancel, 3. And it's actually still really good damage with the type disadvantage. I want to really quickly just go through and see the 4th skill if you just cast it, because there is a lot going on. But if you just cast the 4th skill, you can see that while it does have that initial blast, after that, it's just a small red orb in the middle of the screen. But that small red orb does tremendous damage. And when you couple it with the other buffs that she gets, when you couple it with all of those mind damage and defense down debuffs that you give the enemy, it really starts to stack up. But her second skill, because of the fact that it gives her no protection, is definitely one that you just want to cancel and go. You'll be able to see that when I cancel it into one immediately, the rocks still fly around. Now, there are definitely fewer rocks, so the longer you can hold the second skill, the better. See, I held it there for about an extra half second to a full second, and I got an additional 2 or 3 rocks flying around. So definitely the longer you hold the second skill, the better it is for the damage. But just to get a bit of damage off, just to start the proc, if you're using a damage proc, obelisk is probably the best way to go. Like I said, 2 cancel, 4 cancel, 3. The reason why I'm doing 1 damage right now is because when I use the third skill properly, I actually debuff their, additional damage reduction from blast types, and that's why I was doing semi-regular damage to them. But that's the rotation, and those are the skill kind of interactions with the enemy. The final suggestions I would give you guys for the character, because of the fact that she lost her iframe on her second skill, I think that Scarlet Witch is even more susceptible to guard break than ever before. She got her uniform, a guard break obelisk was still recommended for her. I think the preferred agreed upon best custom gear for her for PvP is the CTP of Authority, because it offers damage, it offers invincibility, it offers the guard break and the accumulated damage, which she doesn't have. If you want to go offensive, the CTP of Destruction is very good because it has the guard break immunity, or you could try to roll something like guard break immunity, mind damage, damage proc. That would be another option for you. So let me know what you guys think of Scarlet Witch's new Infinity War uniform. Let me know what you want to see next from the question earlier. Subscribe if you enjoy the content and you want to support me. Hit the bell if you don't want to miss any of my content. And of course, if you like what you see, I hope to see you again tomorrow. Take care.